Belinda presents this unabridged recording of Random Acts of Fun, Tom Gates, Book 19, written by Liz Pichon and read by Mathew Baynton.
Thank you, Team Scholastic, for all your work on Tom Gates. Catherine, Lauren, Jason, Pete, Andrew, Penelope, Beck, Hannah, Claire, Tony, and all the other brilliant people. As ever, Mark and my lovely family. Lynn, who does so much. Thanks, kiss, kiss. Hello to some
super fans.
Hello, Cleo. Hi, Logan.
Hi, Frankie and Henry.
Hi, Lucy, Isabel and Connor.
Hello, Dante.
New fan. Hello, Zoe.
Martha, hello.
Hi, Otis. Hi, Noah.
Hi, Ethan.
Hello, Hazel.
Hello, Margot.
To Alfie and Archie, kiss. I like having fun. But my idea of fun isn't always the same as everyone else's. Delia looks like she's having fun right now. She's peering round the door and smiling at me. I'm not used to seeing her like that. Hands up, anyone who'd like a wafer? She asks. It's a stupid question, but I answer it anyway. Me, I do. Delia holds out a wafer in her hand, then whips it back when I try and take it. Very funny, I sigh.
I know, isn't it?
She laughs and begins to slowly unwrap the wafer. Hey, I thought that was for me.
I asked if you liked wafers, not if you wanted one.
Normally, I'd just go and get my own wafer from the kitchen, but I can't, thanks to this. I've got a plaster cast on my right foot because I chipped a bone in my ankle. I have to rest and keep my foot propped up on a cushion. Delia sits down next to me on the sofa and makes me bounce up a little. Then she ruffles my hair and says,
Look on the bright side, Tom. No spelling tests at school for a while.
I hadn't thought of that. Oh, yeah, I agree. Or they could send you loads of homework to do. Delia makes a point of saying loads really loudly. That won't happen, I say confidently.
How do you know?
Amber Tully Green broke her arm and she wasn't sent any homework, I tell Delia.
That's because she couldn't use her writing hand, Tom. But you can,
Delia says. She seems to be enjoying herself a bit too much for my liking. She's holding the wafer so close to my nose I can smell the delicious chocolate. It's very distracting.
Do you want some? She asks me.
I pretend not to be interested in case it's another trick question and shrug my shoulders. Delia breaks the wafer in two and offers me the smallest piece. That's not half, I grumble.
Suit yourself,
she says, and goes to eat both pieces. Okay, I'll have it! Delia hands it over and says,
This is fun, isn't it?
Not really. Now, tell me what happened, she adds and points to my foot.
Isn't it obvious?
Dad said you were in a bakery. How did you break your foot in a bakery? I was running to the bakery, I explain, because that sounds a lot better than I was jumping for joy over a donut and I fell over my own feet. As I'm talking, a bit of wafer goes down the wrong way and makes me cough.
Do you need some water?
Delia checks.
Yes, oh, please. I'd get it myself, but I can't move. It's okay, Tom, I'll get you a glass of water.
Delia is being nice to me, which doesn't happen very often, so I'm going to make the most of it. Imagine if I had a little bell to ring when I needed something.
Ding, ding, ding! Delia, I'd love a copy of Rock Weekly, please. Ding, ding, ding! You can take my tray now. Ding, ding, ding! I'd love a blanket to warm my foot.
That would be brilliant. As Delia goes to the kitchen, I call out to her, Delia! Delia! She comes back in a hurry.
What's wrong?
Don't worry, I've just found the remote control. I wasn't worried, Tom, Delia says and gives me a look. I do another small cough to remind her I'm still waiting for my glass of water. Maybe having this plaster cast on will be more fun than I expected. Delia comes back and hands me the water, but it's tricky to drink when you're lying down. I make a small amount of effort to sit up, then I ask for a straw. I don't want to spill it, thanks, Delia, I say, and smile sweetly. A straw? Anything else I can get you? A peeled grape, perhaps? Crisps would be better, I suggest. Delia goes back to the kitchen with a huff. Cheesy puffs, please! I call after her so she knows exactly what I want. Delia comes back with a straw, but there's no sign of my cheesy puffs, which is disappointing. Oh, nothing to eat? I ask, then explain why I want the crisps. Did you know that I collect crisp packets? Yes, Tom, I've smelled them festering in your bedroom. I don't know what festering means, but the way she says it sounds bad. Before I can ask her another question, Delia suddenly whips out a pen. It's my turn to sign your plaster cast. Hang on, no! I try and stop her, but it's too late. Delia is already looming over my foot. She starts writing. Don't touch my toes, I'm ticklish, I say. The way Delia's laughing makes me think she's drawing something silly. There you go. A lovely message from me. I doubt that. What is it? I can't see. It will be a surprise for you, she says, which is annoying. Mum and Dad come and join us, and straight away Dad asks, how are you doing, Tom? I'm a bit hungry. Some crisps would be nice. Delia ruffles my hair again. Good try, Tom. Mum and Dad ignore my crisps comment and start inspecting my foot instead. I wiggle my toes to get their attention. Dad tweaks my little toe and makes me jump. At least they're all in good working order. And talking of working, Mum adds. Huh? Mr. Fullerman has sent a nice message saying you're not to worry about missing your show and tell or any of your other schoolwork. I wasn't worried, I say, which is sort of true. In case they've forgotten, I remind them what the doctor said. Remember, I have to rest for 6 weeks, and the doctor definitely didn't say anything about work. 6 weeks? Really? Dad sounds surprised. They start talking over my head like I'm not even here. But who's going to be looking after Tom when we're both working? Mum wants to know. Bob and Mavis said they'd help out, Dad says. Now I'm thinking about my show and tell in school. I don't want to get into trouble. Not from Mr. Fullerman, but from Delia. I sort of borrowed her signed Dude 3 poster to take into school for my show and tell. And left it there. I need to get it back before Delia spots it's missing, but as I'm stuck at home, that's going to be tricky. While Mum and Dad are still chatting, mostly about me, I turn on the TV to distract myself from thinking about the bad poster situation. And yes! I'm in luck! The Jolly Fruit Bunch is on!
Hoo-hoo!
My favourite. This episode is called The Jolly Fruit Bunch Take a Tumble. As I'm watching, I realise this isn't going to be the distraction I was hoping for. Here's what happened to me before the accident, or BTA. I'd been so focused on going to the new bakery after school for tasty donuts that I'd almost forgotten it was my turn to do the show and tell. What should I talk about? Good question. I could pick 1. My excellent crisp packet collection. I'd shrunk some of them down to turn into really small badges. They all looked brilliant, if I do say so myself. 2. The very old toys. In really ancient times, before there was TV, Mum used to play with these old toys that she keeps in a box. The teddy has a string in its back that you pull. Then, in a growly voice, the teddy would say,
I'm hungry. Will you be my friend? I'm a bear. I love honey.
I got a shock when I first heard it, because the voice sounded just like my Auntie Alice first thing in the morning.
Morning, Tom.
There's also this metal wheel toy that's pretty nifty. You push up the handle really fast to make the wheel spin round. Then blue and red sparks fly off the wheel and it looks amazing in the dark. 3. Or I could bring the Dude 3 poster that was signed by the band. I found it in an envelope on Delia's bedroom table. I don't know why she hasn't put it on her wall. If it was my poster, I'd be showing it off to everyone. Look at my poster! I sat and thought about my show and tell for a very long time. Crisps.
Honey, please.
Dude 3.
Then decided to take the Dude 3 signed poster and the crisps for backup. My plan was to borrow the poster and bring it back the same day. That way Delia would have no idea that it was gone. I'd tell everyone in my class all about how amazing Dude 3 are. Marcus would probably disagree.
Dude 3 is so-so. But then he'd be...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.